The move to video over IP is inevitable, but when will the pros definitely outweigh the cons? Hello and welcome to the fifth and final episode of Connecting OB, discussing the challenges of outside broadcasting. OBs are always being asked to do more cameras, more slow-mo, higher resolution, higher frame rate, but their size and weight continue to be a limiting factor. Even with triple expanding sides, it's still a squeeze to fit everything in and still leave sufficient room for the operators. Traditionally, an OB would have a large central SDI router with all the cables running from the equipment into it. Alongside these cables would be these reference distributions and yet more cables for the control. Using IT technologies for routing and signal distribution offers advantages to the truck designer. Firstly, the powerful IT switches necessary to route video are physically much smaller and lighter than an SDI router, saving valuable space. Having a central IT switch still means that all of the cables need to run back to one spot in the truck, but I'm sure that as the technology matures, distributed switching systems will become more common, reducing the amount of cable. And this brings me on to my second point. The underlying IT connectivity is largely agnostic to the type of data being transported. So video, audio, reference in the form of PTP or precision time protocol, and control can all be carried on a single, probably fibre, cable. This greatly reduces the number of cables to be installed in the truck and also the truck's weight. So here we see a central IT switch with single cables now running from the equipment to it, a single cable from the control panel, and more importantly, a single cable from the SPG carrying the reference signal. Of course, using PTP to lock the equipment in an OB means there is no longer a requirement to distribute separate reference signal. So this gains the truck designer more space where the black and bursty A's would have gone. And talking about reducing the number of distribution amplifiers, the IT switch is also the signal distribution system. Nearly all of the equipment is connected to it, and therefore it is both switch and distributor in one package. Another advantage of distributing video over IP is that both the connecting cables and the switching devices are not limited to any video or audio format. Their only real limitation is how much data can pass in a given time. So assuming sufficient headroom has been allowed in the system, there should be no reason to change the core infrastructure in a truck to accommodate higher picture resolution, higher frame rates, or increased colour space, or indeed all three. A lot of these connections will be based on fibre optic cables, which are less resilient than copper, but there should now be sufficient additional space within the OB to include some form of protection for these cables. And as the IP system is data agnostic, it is possible to use it to carry other signals, such as the HDMI feeds into the multiviewers, and also to bundle signals together, such as video, talkback and cues, and send these over long distances to the talent positions. So using video over IP will solve a lot of problems, right? Well, yes, but not all of them, and not right now. There are still many hurdles to overcome. The common signal format being carried in video over IP systems now is SMPTE 2022-6, which is simply SDI packetized and sent over an Ethernet link. You still need to de-embed the audio if you need to use it, just like SDI. Other formats are being put forward, such as TRO3, where the video, audio and data are carried in separate streams, but none of them are really at the point where manufacturers are including them in their equipment. And not all manufacturers have equipment that currently works with S2022. So OB designs include a large number of SDI to 2022 and 2022 to SDI converters. And also some manufacturers have not adopted PTP. So although the signal is carried as video over IP, the reference is still black and burst. A lot of the equipment is specified with 10 gig E connections, which means if you're going to use UHD, which requires 12 gig, you need to slightly compress the signal. There is no doubt that video IP is the future. Trucks are being built with an IT core, but they also have a large number of modular chassis full of converter cards, and the users are facing challenges in cleanly and reliably switching the signals. Yes, we're on the verge of a large change, but if you have to build a truck, think long and hard before adopting this exciting new technology. Video over IP offers many advantages to IB truck operators, both in terms of reduced size and weight, but also an increased flexibility regarding signal standards and ease of future upgrades. But think hard before committing to it right now. Is this the right time to switch to video over IP? Join the discussion on connectingob.tv or use the hashtag ConnectingOB on Facebook, LinkedIn or Twitter. Thank you for watching ConnectingOB. We hope you've learnt from it and we'll see you next time.